Hello, I'm Beth Ebersol from SAS, and I'm going to talk about how factorization machines can be made easy with SAS visual interfaces. Factorization machines are general predictors that work particularly well with high cardinality and sparse data. One excellent use for factorization machines is recommender systems. So, for example, movies or music tracks that you want to watch can be recommended to you automatically. Supermarkets can figure out which items you might want to buy and give you coupons for those, and so on. In addition to recommender systems, factorization machines can be used to help restore damaged images or damaged film footage. The mathematics behind factorization machines can be a little bit intimidating. The procedure FactMac that SAS uses for factorization machines uses a stochastic gradient descent optimizing solver that can be highly parallelized. But you don't need to know all the details of that because we have two wonderful visual interfaces. One is Visual Analytics that lets you do factorization machines, and the other is SAS Model Studio. With these visual interfaces, it's very easy to use factorization machines, which I'll demonstrate. Let's take the example of recommender systems for movies. The data are very sparse, and they can be a huge data set. Two categorical inputs, one is movies and one is movie watchers, like you and me, and there can be thousands of movies and thousands of watchers, and most people have not seen most movies, which creates a sparse, high cardinality data set. And this is where factorization machines really shine. Here I am in Visual Analytics. The first step is to bring in my data, which is very easy to do. I just go here, select to add data, and under choose data, I'm going to import from local file. I'm going to grab this ratings data. It's a CSV file. I'm going to put it in the target of my own cast user, which is this cast user Bieber. I'm going to bring it in as a SAS HDAP file, and I'm going to replace it if I already have it. I'm going to call it Beth Ratings 2. We see the table was successfully imported and is ready for our use. I'll select OK. Here we see the movie ID came in as a measure, but we want it as a category. Often ID numbers are recognized as numbers, which they are numbers, but they're recognized as measures, but they're actually a category. We'll also change our user ID to a category. The rating, we're going to change the default aggregation to average from sum. And we can look at these quickly if we want to in a list table. I'll add, for example, movie ID and rating. So you can see we have the average rating here. But we're not really interested in a list table. That just lets us look at the data. We actually want to do factorization machine. So I opened up a new page and I'm going to drag in factorization machine from the left. You see it's under SAS Visual Data Mining and Machine Learning. We also have another category of SAS Visual Statistics, which also has models, but the machine learning models are down here on the left. I'll assign data. The response will be the rating, and the predictors will be the movie ID and the user ID. We see here our average squared error is 0.7. We can also look at the observed average and the sum of squares error. We have over 100,000 observations. We can see the iteration plot with loss plotted by iteration, and you can see how that goes down over the number of iterations. We have our scored response, which is the predicted value by the actual value. And we have the top recommendation. So we have the top ranked movie ID here. And we look at our predicted average with our observed average, and it looks pretty good. So we're going to go ahead and create a pipeline. This moves us into Model Studio, where we have more flexibility. Visual Analytics is very automated. SAS Model Studio lets the user have a little bit more control if they would like it. We'll add to a new project. So you see we have now a pipeline with our data node, the visual data preparation, what happened with the data preparation in Visual Analytics, the factorization machine that was just everything was default, and the model comparison, so we can run this pipeline. So now the pipeline has run. We can look at our factorization machine results. And you see one great thing, we have the score code here, the Path EP score code. We have the DS2 package code. We have the score inputs, which were movie ID and user ID. We have the score outputs. So we have the EM prediction, the P rating, the VA filter. We have all our properties. The options that were set for us by default are shown here. And we can look at our assessment. And we have the actual and predicted by depth or the predicted by actual. And we have our fit statistics here. So for example, root mean squared error, mean absolute error, etc. We can also look at our output data. We'll just look at 10 rows. Here we see the prediction for rating, which is the same as the predicted rating for every movie ID by user ID combination, then we see the actual rating. So you can see many times it was pretty close. This one was a little off, but this just gives us a subsample of our results. So we see how easy it was to use factorization machines and let everything be automated. We can also, if we want to have a little more control, we could add another factorization machine node here. And we can decide if we want to perform auto-tuning or not. So you see if we perform auto-tuning, the number of factors are here, the maximum iterations, the learning step size, the search method could be Bayesian, genetic algorithm, grid, Latin hypercube, sample, or random. We can adjust these or we can just go with the auto-tuning. I'm going to rename this FM auto-tune and I'll run that. We see the partial pipeline has run and we can again look at the results. We have our iteration plot, our biases and factors, our final exact loss. Remember, we were auto-tuning, so we weren't going with the defaults. We were letting the software use auto-tuning optimization methods to get the best hyperparameters. We also, again, have our EP score code and our DS2 package code, our score inputs, our training code, our score outputs, our properties, and our output. And we have our actual and predicted by depth or by predicted by actual. And we have our fit statistics. Again, we could look at our output data, but let's close this. And let's look at our model comparison. We'll right-click and look at the results of the model comparison. And we see that our auto-tuned model did better with an average squared error of 0.64. And we can see the other errors. We can see the selection criteria class was the Kolmogorov-Smirnov statistic, and the selection criteria interval was the average squared error. And we could play around with this factorization machine. We just went with the defaults, the easy route. To improve our model, we could, number one, use more data, a larger data set. I used a subsample of the data set so it wouldn't take too long to run for this demonstration. We could use more data to improve our model. And the other thing we could do is mess around with the factorization machine if we have those kind of skills and want to set the hyperparameters ourselves. For more information, see the following resources. I'm Beth Ebersole with SAS. I hope this was helpful.